Hello children, how are you all? Hope you all are fine and doing well. We appreciate you, dear children. All of you have responded very well in the previous class and even submitted your assignments. I hope you will enjoy even today's class and benefit from it. Now, before we begin our class, let us invoke God's blessings on each one of us. Let us join our hands and close our eyes. God, our Heavenly Father, we thank and praise you for the gift of this new day. Thank you, Lord, for all your blessings on each one of us. Bless our families and the whole world. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Dear children, being in Mangalore, you all may be very familiar with the seashore and the beach, isn't it? Most of you are very fond of playing in the beach. Yes. Today, let me tell you an incident which happened long ago. Titanic ship was the biggest and most beautiful ship that was ever built. It was so beautiful, like a palace. It had all the facilities. It was well built. It was built by Edward and Wolf Shipbuilders. Edward Smith was the captain of this ship. On 10th April 1912, the ship started its voyage. But on the way, what happened was, because of the bad weather, the French ships reminded the Titanic ship not to continue the journey. But the captain of the ship, Edward Smith, did not care. He did not listen to it. Even in our lives, dear children, many of the times our elders or our parents may tell us not to do certain things. But with overconfidence, we think we know everything and continue to do. And finally, we land into disaster, isn't it? Okay, let us see what happened to our Titanic ship after this. On 15th April, the magnificent ship hit against the iceberg. Even after many, many reminders, the ship moved and finally it hit against the iceberg. As a result, 1,513 passengers drowned and died in it. See, the amount of people died, lost their lives in this incident. Dear children, human persons have tried their best to develop resources and rule over the earth, but they have not been able to control the nature. No one has the authority to control the nature. God alone has the authority over the nature. Today, though we are able to travel at a supersonic speed, we have not been able to reduce the accidents. Perhaps our speed has caused more death. Every day we see so many accidents taking place, isn't it? God is the master of heaven and earth. He alone has the authority over the nature. So, why did I tell about God's authority in today's class? The title of our lesson is, Why Are You Afraid? Where do you hear these words of Jesus? Some of you might have already guessed it. When Jesus calms the storm, Jesus tells these words to his disciples. Let us read this gospel passage from the Bible. I request you all to take your gospels. It's in the Mark chapter 5, verses 35 to 41. On that day, When the evening had come, he said to them, "Let us go across to the other side." And leaving the crowd behind, they took him with him in the boat, just as he was. Other boats were with him. A great windstorm arose, and the waves beat into the boat, so that the boat was already being swamped. But he was in stern, asleep on the cushion. And they woke him and said to him, "Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?" He woke up and rebuked the wind and said to the sea, "Peace, be still." Then the wind ceased and there was a dead calm. He said to them, "Why are you afraid? Have you still no faith?" And they were filled with great awe and said to one another, "Who then is this that even the wind and the sea obey him?" Dear children, Jesus' disciples, some of them were fishermen and they knew very well swimming. But when the wind arose, when the storm came, they were afraid and called on to Jesus. The moment Jesus said, "Be still," and the ocean became still, became peace. Dear children, storms in the sea are very normal. In the same way, struggles, pains, and difficulties also normal in our life. On our life's journey, we often become the victims of storms. And what will happen? We too get frightened and lose heart. But if we call out Jesus, he will surely come to our help and enabling us to overcome the storms of life. He will grant us peace. Therefore, like the disciples of Jesus, let us humbly call out the name of Jesus in our difficulties. And I am sure Jesus will deliver us from every danger and evil. Let us take our difficulties to Jesus. Dear children, in our life, one thing we have to remember forever, that is, there is no biggest problem that our God cannot solve. Everything is possible with God. If we have Jesus in our lives, everything is possible. Nothing is impossible with God. There is no problem that is biggest that our God cannot solve. Dear children, if we have Jesus as the captain of our boat, we can do everything. We can overcome any storms of life. Dear children, all of us like to be happy and joyful, isn't it? Nobody likes to be sad or moody. So, when we have difficulties, what is our first step? Let us take all our difficulties to Jesus, and surely he will help us. When we face difficulties, let us share those difficulties with our parents and elders. Surely they will come to our help. Jesus will come to our help in the form of our parents or elders or our friends. Dear children, a very few days ago, we had an occasion to celebrate. And what was that feast? That is the feast of Saint Joachim and Anne. And who are they? They were the parents of Mother Mary. That's meaning to say they were the grandparents of Jesus himself. See, Jesus too had his grandparents. Saint Anne and Joachim They lived a beautiful and a holy life, and even they brought up Mother Mary in holiness. In honor of them, we celebrate this day as Grandparents' Day, and our Holy Father has given us a call to celebrate this day as Grandparents' Day. Dear children, our grandparents are very experienced. They are the source and jewels of life experiences. They have gone through the life. They have faced all the difficulties and storms of life. As the hen gathers his chicks under his wings, our grandparents unite us. So we need to keep them happy, make them feel special. So dear children, now we have come to the end of our class. I hope you all will enjoy doing these activities. We have just heard in the class, there is no difficulties, there is no big problem that Jesus cannot solve. So let us make Jesus as the captain of our boat. As a symbol of this, in your notes, the activity is draw the picture of a boat and stick a picture of Jesus and give the caption to it, Jesus is the captain of my boat. And then you have few fill in the blanks. I hope you all will enjoy finding out these answers from the same gospel passage. Answers are there only, and you all can find out the correct answer and fill it. And dear children, you all have one more additional activity. That is, in your own creative and simple way, prepare card or drawing or with flowers, wish your grandparents in honor of Grandparents' Day. And share these photos in the class group. In the Catechism class group, you all can share these photos. Okay, dear children, I hope you all will enjoy doing all these activities. Thank you, dear children. I hope you all enjoyed this class. Let us meet in the next class. Let us end our class by saying glory be. Glory be to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Thank you, dear children. God bless you all. Have a blessed and happy Sunday.